Over the past year, it seems as if every productivity tool has included AI as a part of its feature. But in many cases, I've been very disappointed. Either they're adding AI to something that doesn't make sense or actually doesn't improve the product, and even when they do add it to something that might be helpful, the results are often very poor. Fortunately, that's not the case with Walling, one of my favorite productivity tools, especially when it comes to creating projects, proposals, and if you're wanting to share those things with other clients or people outside of your team. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to use AI in Walling and get the most out of this new feature. So here I am within my Walling account, and typically we have two options to get started. We can either begin with a completely blank wall, or we can come down here to the many excellent templates. But I think with this new AI generate feature, you may never come back to these templated options because we can get so much further, so much faster by just giving it a little bit of instruction. So all we need to do is click on AI generate and tell it in a brief description what exactly it is that we are looking for. So in this example, perhaps I want to create a marketing plan for a real estate business in Seattle. I'm going to take on the role of a marketing consultant, and I'm working with this client, and I want to put together a quick plan so I can show them what I'm capable of doing for them and to get them to sign a contract by the end of the week. So I've given it just a brief direction here, exactly what I stated, marketing plan for a real estate business in Seattle. And all I have to do is hit enter, and in just a few seconds, it's provided me with a complete project proposal with all of the details necessary for me to get started. It's even included a checklist, bullet points, a table, even a Kanban board in terms of how we can move forward with this project, even has included pictures that I can use as a part of this proposal. And unlike using a generic template where we could probably find a marketing plan, in fact, there's probably a number of marketing plan templates out there. If we read in the details here of the overview, the objectives, if we go into the actual bullet points, these are things specific to both the Seattle area, but also the real estate market. If I come down here to the bottom under market analysis, it knows a little bit about the Seattle real estate market and the strong economy, low employment rate, yet a high demand for real estate. So this is a lot more specific. It allows me to not have to fill in so many blanks. I can focus on the key points and move on with my proposal. So let's quickly go through the different sections of this wall, which it has provided. And remember, for each prompt or each instruction that you give it, it's going to come out with a different layout depending on what you are wanting. So here at the top, I have the combination of a cover image and a title. Of course, if I want to come here and change this cover, let's see if we can find something that is a little more specific to Seattle. Yes, that speaks Seattle to me. So we can quickly and easily change these images. We've got an executive summary, which is going to cover the overview and the objectives of this marketing plan. It goes over some of the metrics that we are going to use and a combination of bullet points and a checklist here. And of course, if I want to change something, I can click on absolutely anything and delete or add it or edit. In this example here of evaluation and measurement, it might not make that much sense to have a checklist here unless I'm wanting to work through this with the client. But because I'm going to be using this page as a proposal, I'm going to come over here and I want to turn this into a bulleted list. So again, in just a few keystrokes, I can make those simple changes. Here it's even provided me with a budget and a timeline. And think, with just that one key prompt, it's given me a couple of tasks to get started on. Here's the estimated time or estimated cost, who it's assigned to, and then the due date. Of course, I can add as many additional columns or additional rows as I would like, but it's already got me started with a fantastic beginning. And then below, under marketing strategies, it's given me a great view here of the different areas, the online marketing, local advertising, and partnerships. It's put it into a Kanban style board here so I can clearly see the differences that we are going to engage in or the different possibilities that we have for this plan. And then lastly, we have our market research area here at the end. And don't forget, it's not just easy to edit the text, but we can completely edit the layout and swap out other pieces of information. So for example, since we're talking about market research for a real estate project, it doesn't make that much sense that it's giving me these microscopes here. So I'm gonna come up here and say replace. Let's type in something like real estate, see what it comes back with. And I think this makes a lot more sense. But if I want to go and grab images or video, here I've got a short video to show how I do my market research. I can simply drag and drop it directly into my wall. So now when they receive this proposal, they'll be able to quickly and easily play this video when they view this screen. And then if I want some other things to stand out, such as maybe this competitor research, I want to have just a different shade, just so that they see the difference between these sections, I can do so here as well. But the AI doesn't stop with just generating your wall. We can continue to add further sections and add further content within our wall. So for example, maybe at the bottom of the wall, I want to stress why they should be working with me, and maybe what do they stand to lose if they don't work with my organization. So I'm gonna click on new section here, and although I can start to add my own details, I'm going to continue and select AI generate. Now again, we are asked for a prompt, but here we don't have to give as much detail. In fact, instead of giving it instruction, I'm just going to give it a simple title for this section, why you should work with us. I'm gonna hit enter, and now in just a few seconds, it's given me a great summary paragraph, a great way to sign off and encourage them to complete this proposal or at least continue the conversation. Now, you may be asking, how do I share this with others safely and without having to confuse my clients or the people that I'm working with, adding them to Walling, giving them a login? Well, remember, you can share your proposal, your page, your wall, whatever you build here with or without AI using the publishing tool at the top of the screen. So here I'm going to come up to the top and I'm going to select publish. And when I'm happy with it, all I need to do is select publish to the web, and now I can safely share this link. If I open up a new incognito window, I'm going to paste in this link. This is exactly what they will see, but in a much nicer format. In fact, what I really love about this formatting is that it gives a nice clickable table of contents on the left-hand side, so they can quickly and easily go to different sections of this proposal in just a few clicks. But wait a minute, maybe I don't want to share the budget and timeline because we haven't discussed those details yet and I didn't want to introduce a budget at this point. Well, no problem. When I go back to my Walling account and access the publish page, I can choose which sections I want or do not want to include when sharing the page. So in this case, I'm going to uncheck budget and timeline. Now, when I go to share this wall with others, they will see everything on this screen except for this particular section. So you can create something full and complete, but only share the sections that you desire. And since more and more people are doing more of their work on a mobile device, such as a phone or a tablet, don't worry, Walling has got you covered with a completely responsive design. So no matter what device they use, your proposal or project will look professional and contain all the information that you've included. So now that you know how quickly and easily you can create a project or a proposal and share it with others, what do you need to get done today? What's something that you're behind on or something that you're dreading getting started? Instead of staring at a blank page, why don't you let AI generate something for you, which will get you 80% of the way there. To get started with Walling, go to walling.app or click the link in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.